Well, welcome and good afternoon. Mayor John Nook of the Village of Romeoville, and welcome to our community. And we're very proud to host this event today for a program that I must say, and I think for a lot of people at home, you know, the Silver Search program, you talk about stuff that the state's done more recently. This is really something I think is just outstanding. You know, I know a lot of people who've been touched by Alzheimer's or any potential, you know, thing that may affect someone's memory or their cognitive abilities. And, you know, in fact, my own grandmother, you know, passed away after many years of suffering from Alzheimer's. And just the thought of losing someone so special or being out of communication with them, it can be very heart-wrenching. And I must say that you know, you hear a lot of negative things about our state, and there's a lot of tough things, but I think the people that are here today and we're going to talk about this program are just some outstanding individuals. And I really want to thank our own state senator, or state representative Natalie Manley, and for being a part of this, and also state senator Biss also, and all the members of the committee that are here that have been a part of this. I know, again, being someone who worries oftentimes about those in their families that are hit by and touched by this, that means a lot to all of us. And here in our community, we have so many, especially seniors, that are potentially vulnerable to something like this, and so many of their families that, you know, we take pride in making sure that our seniors are taken care of. And whether it's a senior or anybody in any point in their life that may be affected, we're glad that this program's out there and that there's ways to help. So we're proud to be a part of this, and welcome to Romeo. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you for your hospitality and beautiful facilities that we have here today. My name is Craig Burge. I'm the Missing Persons Coordinator for Illinois State Police, and I also chair the Silver Search Task Force. On behalf of the task force, I'd like to welcome everybody here today for the unveiling of this Silver Search program. First off, I would like to acknowledge and thank both Senator Daniel Biss and Representative Nancy Manley behind me today. Both were chief sponsors of this legislation in their chambers, and we couldn't have done it without their support, so thank you. I also have a few members of the Silver Search Task Force with me here today. I have Erna Colburn, who's the Illinois Chapter Executive of the Alzheimer's Association. The Alzheimer's Association has been a huge partner with us from the beginning of this program. Without them, none of this would have ever gotten off the ground. So we want to thank them for their hard work and their dedication to this. We have Dennis Lyle, who is the President and CEO of the Illinois Broadcasters Association. The expertise and knowledge that he brings as far as our public awareness you know, campaigns is going to be very, very much needed as we go forward. We're here today because no one ever wants to get the news that somebody goes missing. It's even more devastating when you talk about somebody that has Alzheimer's or dementia. It's at times like these where we need to utilize the available resources to return that person home safely. I think we'd all agree that returning them home as quickly as possible is the goal. But how do we make that goal a reality? Well, it started with a process in the Capitol building several months ago, where multiple parties sat down and discussed ways in which we could make this public safety initiative a reality. We needed to decide and to make available education, public awareness, and other technologies so that we can help find those that with Alzheimer's or dementia that go missing. And we can do that in a more efficient and effective way. We finally believe that we have reached our ultimate public safety goal. In doing so, the only way we could get there is by a collaborative effort between multiple parties and multiple entities involved. And that's what Silver Search is. Silver Search is all of these parties getting together as a task force and meeting regularly over the last year to design and build a system in which we can utilize to return those people home that have Alzheimer's or dementia. These participating agencies have worked tirelessly to bring their expertise to the table, to provide whatever resources necessary at their disposal to help with this end goal. As a missing persons coordinator for Illinois, many times I've reached out to other states, some of my surrounding states and counterparts throughout the country. I've heard of some good stories and some bad stories with their systems. I can honestly say that the system that we're putting together and the collaborative effort that we have in the state of Illinois is far and away better than any other program that's going on right now in this country. Silver Search is truly a model for all the other states to achieve, and also a game changer when it comes to finding those with Alzheimer's or dementia. And I'm proud to say that we are here today to support this endeavor. So following some comments by the rest of our panel here, I will come back up and discuss a few ways in which technology and resources are going to be utilized to help us with this end goal. Right now, I'd like to bring up Representative Natalie Manley.
Thank you, Craig. Hello, everybody. Welcome. Good afternoon. Today is a great day. We are celebrating doing the right thing in Illinois for some of Illinois' most vulnerable citizens and their families. I am very proud to stand here with some of those who made the Silver Search program a reality. Lots of hard work, dedication, all geared toward a common goal, and that goal being ensuring the safe return of any individual with Alzheimer's that goes missing. With over 220,000 people living here in Illinois with a diagnosis of Alzheimer's, 6 in 10 will go wandering at some time during the course of that disease. Just yesterday, a man from Chicago got in his car. He was diagnosed with Alzheimer's, got in his car, and his family couldn't find him. They eventually found him, actually in Bolingbroke. Fortunately, he was okay. That does not always happen. But in his case, I was glad to hear that he was returned to his family safely. In my district, you're in my district right now, this is the 98th House District, I represent several very large retirement communities. And although we know Alzheimer's is not only a disease that affects the elderly, when I heard about the legislation, when the Illinois chapter of the Alzheimer's Association came and asked me and told me about the bill, I immediately went to my constituents to talk about it. Many of Alzheimer's patients are cared for by a family member. And this is oftentimes over long periods of time, and not only can this be exhausting, but it's always heartbreaking for them. So when I approached some of my constituents, told them about the bill, I was overwhelmed by some of the stories that I heard. One story in particular stands out to me, and I'd like to share it with you if I could briefly. A woman and her husband had been married many, many years. He had been diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease, probably, I think at the time she was telling me about 6 or 7 years. And the few months before I met her and heard the story, she said things had gotten worse. It's a progressive disease, it always gets worse. And they had several sleepless nights. And she herself was older, and she was exhausted. And she had sat down in a chair, and her husband was in the other room resting. And she thought, I'm just going to close my eyes for a couple of minutes. When she opened her eyes, when she woke up, he was gone. So this story has a happy ending. Their son did locate her husband and brought him back home safely. But the thing that was really astonishing and what struck me the most was that she felt so guilty. And she kept trying to explain to me why she had to shut her eyes. And I wanted her to know that there are people that are, and we do not have a cure for this disease. But while we are working on that, there are things that we can do as a community, as a government, to provide resources and support for these people that are going through these difficult times. So I took her story back to the Illinois House. I talked to my colleagues, both Republicans and Democrats, about, at the time, Senate Bill 1846. And I am proud to say that it was passed through the House unanimously. Alzheimer's is an insidious disease. It takes our loved ones from us long before their hearts stop beating. And while we continue to find a cure, we need to stand up and do what we can to help these people get through these difficult times. We need to help our husbands and our wives, our grandparents, our mothers, our fathers, our sisters, our brothers, our aunts, our uncles, and many times now our children through this difficult time. Senator Biss, I want to thank you for your leadership in the House. Mayor Noak, thank you. We have many of the same constituencies. I know that his caring, his level of caring and dedication to this community is makes me very proud to serve this community and work alongside him. I was, oftentimes it's difficult, especially in the last couple of years, to find moments where you can actually be proud of the work you're doing. The Silver Search program, the people that I've worked with, make me very proud. Illinois did really good this time, and so I thank you. I'd like to invite Senator Daniel Biss to the podium, and thank you all for being here.
Good afternoon. All right, look alive. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
There it is. Thank you, Representative Manley, for your extraordinary leadership on this and so many other issues. Thank you to the Village of Romeoville, to Mayor Noak, for your hospitality, for your support of this important cause. And thank you, everyone, for being a part of this conversation. I'm Daniel Biss, State Senator in the 9th District, Chief Sponsor of Senate Bill 1846. And I just want to say two things. Number one, this is an exciting day. This is an exciting day when we have the opportunity to roll out a program that will actually change lives and save lives in the state of Illinois. We have an aging population. We have a growing, frightening Alzheimer's epidemic. Growth in the number of people suffering from dementia. This enormously gut-wrenching challenge of relatives wandering off and not being easily found again is one that affects way too many families in the state of Illinois. And as we think about the work that we are doing to move to a moment when Alzheimer's has been fully cured, we also acknowledge that right now the aging of the population is ahead of that progress. And so we have a lot of work to do to provide the needed supports to individuals suffering from Alzheimer's and other forms of dementia, and crucially, to their caregivers, to their families, to their loved ones. This Silver Search program does that. But I also want to say that as we sit here in November, actually, it's a new month, as we sit here in November of 2017 and talk about how proud we are of this accomplishment and how pleased we are of the collaboration that's going to ensue to enable our state to help support individuals and families in need of help, it can look inevitable. But it wasn't. When Natalie and I began to hear from the Alzheimer's Association in 2015, this was all but inevitable. When we started to sit down and have conversations with the various different stakeholders, from law enforcement, from nonprofits, health professionals, government, of course, private activists, there were moments that those negotiations were difficult. There were moments that it wasn't clear if we were going to be successful. I want to thank Craig for the amount of time that you put in, the work and the effort and the collaboration required to make sure that we got to a good resolution. But we got there. And we got there because of the dogged work of not just dozens, but many hundreds of people from around the state who were committed to working together to find a way forward to actually produce a program that would be beneficial to many, many people. And so I just want to say thank you to all the people, many of whom are here in this room, many, many more of whom are not in this room right now, but who are thinking of us, who were crucial to enable this day to come to pass, and who and their families will benefit from this program now that it's been rolled out. This is the way that government ought to work. This is the kind of collaboration that we ought to be able to engage in on every single issue, every single day,
to enable our communities to move forward. And I just want to thank especially the Alzheimer's Association for the work that you did to enable us to come to this point and to demonstrate that when we sit down and work together with the goal of bettering our own communities and the lives of our own relatives and loved ones, there's no limit on what we can accomplish. Thank you very much.
Well, good afternoon. I'm Erna Colborn, and I'm the chapter executive for the Illinois chapter of the Alzheimer's Association. More than 220,000 people in Illinois have Alzheimer's disease, and 588,000 Illinois residents are caregivers for those folks. Alzheimer's spares no nationality, no political party, no economic status. In fact, we all share the biggest risk factor, which is having a brain. Receiving a diagnosis of Alzheimer's is awful, but on top of that, the fact that 60% of those with Alzheimer's will wander during the course of their disease is a real pivotal factor for us today. At the Alzheimer's Association, we have heard story after story after story, such as Representative Manley shared with us, of loved ones gone missing, sometimes with very tragic endings, and caregivers who are feeling helpless. This is why our priority in Illinois is to make our state dementia capable until a cure or a prevention is found. Together with the Illinois State Police, the Illinois Broadcasters Association, and the rest of the task force, we now have comprehensive protocols that will make sure that resources are available to help bring those persons home safe. I want to extend my sincere gratitude to both Senator Biss and Representative Manley. Without their determination and hard work, we would not be standing here today to celebrate and unveil this new program. The Alzheimer's Association is immensely grateful to you for advocating on behalf of those affected by this devastating disease. I also want to thank the task force and especially the Illinois State Police. Silver Surge will save lives. It's been said before, but I'm going to say it again. This is a game changer for our state. The Alzheimer's Association is pleased to be here today and grateful to have these amazing partners to work with as we improve the lives of those living with Alzheimer's or a related dementia in Illinois. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Dennis Lyle, President and CEO of the Illinois Broadcasters Association, and I too want to congratulate Representative Manley and Senator Biss on this outstanding legislation, and to the Alzheimer's Association and the Illinois State Police and working collectively on passing just a remarkable piece of legislation, so my compliment to them. As the Broadcasters Association, we represent the many radio and television broadcast stations throughout the state of Illinois. Whereas the state police are the first responders, we like to think of us in the media as the first informers. We tell the story. You heard reference to stories here from the podium earlier this afternoon. There are a lot of stories to tell about Alzheimer's and dementia patients and people who wander off, and unfortunately not all those stories end in a positive note. But thanks to this legislation, perhaps there won't even be a story other than to perhaps report that there is someone missing. We were chatting yesterday when we were comparing notes, and if someone is entering an area now where a dementia patient or an Alzheimer patient has wandered off, if you're in your car, you probably hear about it on your radio. If you're on the highway or tollway or expressway, you're going to see it on a sign. If you stop and get gasoline, thanks to the lottery folks, you're going to see it on one of their terminals. And so the good news is, thanks to the many tools that are associated with this legislation and with this development of the task force, which we're so proud to be a member of, there may not be a story, but I'm hopeful that if there is a story, it's a happy ending for us to report. And again, we so appreciate being part of this task force. Thank you.
So Dennis kind of stole some of my thunder of what I was going to tell you we were going to do here. But I just wanted to say that it's definitely fitting that we're doing this
on November 1st, since it kicks off the Alzheimer's Disease Awareness and National Family Caregiver Month. So it all kind of fits in line. When we did sit down as a task force and understood the totality of the situation, we understood that there was probably three main areas that we needed to focus on so that we could help so many families that are dealing with this type of situation. The first area that we were focused on was training. If you talk to a lot of law enforcement officers, they can tell you that they've been trained on this or they've been trained on that. Alzheimer's and the effects have changed significantly and have increased significantly enough that we need to notify and train those local law enforcement. Those law enforcement officers that are, and first responders and telecommunicators out there that are getting these calls when somebody wanders. They're getting these calls when somebody disappears in their vehicles. So what can they do? What are their responses going to be? So as we kick off the Silver Search campaign today in our website, silversearchillinois.org, our first area that we're going to focus on is training. We're going to train 2,500 law enforcement officers across the state. Also, any type of dispatchers or anybody working with the law enforcement profession. We're going to train you on the how to handle these situations, because these situations are time sensitive. And we need to make sure that we deal and handle these appropriately. We're going to work with our partnerships with the Illinois Law Enforcement Trainings and Standards Board and also the Illinois Association of Chief of Police to make sure that this new curriculum is taught in all law enforcement academies for all new police officers. We have some police officers in the room today, so you will see and have the ability to come to these trainings and participate in what this Silver Search program will mean for you. The second area that we're going to focus on is technology. We have the first responders, we have the resources, we get out there. What resources, what technology can we utilize so that we can inform the public to be our eyes and ears? How can the public get us information about the whereabouts of this person that wanders or this person that's mobile in their vehicle? With that, we're going to utilize the hundreds of digital message signs that are across our interstates and tollways throughout Illinois. We're going to, similar to what you see here today, flash a sign up there showing that we're looking for that endangered missing person. We're going to show them the license plate and the vehicle information in hopes that they respond to law enforcement upon a sighting of that. We will also use the 7,700 different lottery retail locations throughout Illinois and the 9,000 digital lottery displays that you'll see at these locations. It's similar to the ones where when you go to your local gas station or convenience store and you see a digital board sitting there next to the cashier. Those boards will be taken over by a picture of the missing person, by the vehicle information of the missing person that we're looking for, in hopes that somebody that's filling up gas has seen that car, has seen that license plate vehicle sometime during their travels. We hope that these technologies will greatly enhance law enforcement's ability to get the information to the public, like I said, in hopes that they will give us the information back about any possible sightings about the whereabouts of the person. Finally, the third part is our public awareness campaign. Today, like I said, we're kicking off, first of all, with the website silversearchillinois.org. That will be a one-stop shop for everybody to go to find out all of this information, for law enforcement to get the forms and the education that they need, for caregivers and loved ones to go out there and find out what they can do to help. SilverSearchIllinois.org will be the place that we send everybody from here on out in the future. Like Dennis mentioned, we will be doing public service announcements, and these public service-like announcements will help notify the families, notify the guardians and the caregivers about this issue, and where to go if they need support. You will hear them on television, you will hear them on radio throughout Illinois, you'll see them on billboards, and in social media outlets that we have available out there. We feel it's important that the public knows, once again, that silversearchillinois.org is the place to go, and we are the task force behind making that the one-stop shop for all the needs of Silver Search. And with that, I'm going to turn it over or ask if there's any other, if there's any questions from anybody today, for anybody. Mayor, if you'd like to.
Well, again, I want to thank the entire group and for being here today. You know, I also want to take a quick moment. I want to thank the first responders that are here in the room today. You know, we heard about the telecommunicators and the caregivers that work day in, day out to help these individuals and those that may be watching. I also want to make, not something we always do, but a pitch here for the Alzheimer's Association. Whether they knew how intimately it affected me personally, I've helped out their organization, but please educate yourself about their cause if you can help, if you have the means. Please consider it. But not as just as a mayor, but as again, as a family member touched by this personally, I want to thank everybody up here, and I especially want to thank State Representative Manley and Senator Biss on leading this effort. It means so much to all those families. I'll just let you know that. And again, I want to thank everybody for coming here and joining us today in Romeoville, and we'll all work together on this important cause. Thank you.
Thank you.